title of the work presented is Predictive and Stochastic Algorithm for Multiple Local Alignment of Interaction Networks.
So hello to everybody. I'm Giovanni Micali from the University of Pisa, and I'm going to present an algorithm for multiple local alignment of biological networks. We will briefly describe the problem and its sampling, which is at the heart of this algorithm. And we will describe the algorithm, and we show results on six PPI networks. So the problem is the following. We want to detect concept complexes of proteins which are involved in similar processes or functions across two or more species. And we want to build an optimal mapping between nodes of different networks in order to maximize a proper defined score. And the problem is related to subgraph isomorphism, which is known to be NP-complete. So we need heuristics. And we have two inputs for the problem. We are given n weighted networks, one per species, where weights are probabilities of interaction between proteins, and plus bit scores between authors to compute non topological similarity between proteins. And our algorithm, Gasolin, has two key features. It's greedy because it uses a seek-extend approach to look for concept patterns. And it's stochastic because it's based on deep sampling. And in order to find an optimal one-to-one mapping between nodes. I give you a brief description of deep sampling, and I concentrate my attention to the application to Markov chains, because Professor Lorenz already talked about deep sampling this morning. The problem is the following. We can use deep sampling to build a Markov chain whose stationary distribution phi is p, which is the joint probability distribution defined here. And generate samples according to this distribution. And we can start from a Markov chain where states are different assignments of values to n variables and random variables. And we build a new sample by giving a new assignment to a random variable, and we obtain a transition from one state to another state of the chain. And if our Markov chain models a problem, and we iterate deep sampling enough, we can finally build samples representing the probable solution to the problem, and we can actually start from any initial distribution and any random state. A relevant application of deep sampling is local sequence alignment, developed by Lorenz in 1991, and there's a mistake, it's 1993, and we are given n sequences, L1, L2, Ln, and an integer W, and we want to find the n segments of W characters, one for each sequence, maximizing a sequence similarity on this part, and finally align the sequences according to these common patterns. The deep sampling strategy for local sequence alignment is the following. We consider the set of segments of size W in each sequence, and sequences are associated with random variables, and the values of these random variables are the segments. We build a Markov chain where states are different combinations of n segments, one for each sequence. Then we start from a randomly alignment. We choose randomly a segment from each sequence, and then we build an initial alignment, k. Then we iterate this procedure. We extract randomly a segment AK from A. We replace AK with a segment X of size W of the same sequence according to a transition probability P. And we add X to A. This transition probability is defined based on background frequencies of characters and on the frequencies of characters within the partial alignment, within the segments of the partial alignment. And we iterate this procedure k times, and we return the alignment. Now we describe our solution to the problem. We start with some preprocessing on the input. We consider the set of sets of nodes in each network. We call this set S. Then we remove from each SI proteins that have no autologs in at least one species. And we remove proteins having no degree less than a fixed threshold vector. We can remove these nodes because they are not essential for the alignment, for the final alignment. They won't be considered for the alignment. The algorithm is the following. We have an initial phase where we try to apply this sampling twice, starting from alignment of single nodes, to find, if possible, an optimal alignment of similar X, and we call this initial seeds. Then we go to the refinement phase. We iteratively remove nodes from seeds and add nodes to the alignment by applying deep sampling until a score which is called the IBSC score is above a threshold delta. Then we perform the updating phase. We save the biggest alignment found in the refinement phase, and we remove nodes of initial seeds from S, so that they won't be considered in the next step. And we iterate these three steps until one of the SI is empty. The deep sampling strategy for local network alignment is similar to the one we saw for local sequence alignment, but instead of same sequences we have networks, and instead of segments we have nodes. So we consider the set of nodes, and we associate random variables to networks, and values are nodes. Nodes labels, and we build a macro chain where states are different combination of these nodes labels, and then we choose randomly one node from each network, and we build an initial alignment, and then we iterate the same procedure. We extract randomly a node from A. We replace this node with another node from the same network according to a transition probability which is defined based on sequence similarity, I mean ortology similarity, relation between proteins, and topological similarity between nodes, and we add X to the alignment, and then we return the final alignment. We tested our algorithm to a data set of six PPI networks taken from a stream database, and we chose the following parameters for delta and sigma, and we performed a statistical validation by annotating proteins with geo categories in order to find the most significant and conserved ones, and we performed a comparison with the network plus demo, which is the current state of art. And species, we consider that thousands of proteins and tens of thousands PPIs, more or less. And these are the best alignments we found in Gaussly. And these alignments have variable size. instead of this is different from network blasting, which all the alignments found are having the same size, the same number of nodes. And we can observe that all the highest scoring alignments found by Gasolin are also among the best scored alignments found by network blast. So there is they have similar results. They show similar results. And most complexes are actually found by both algorithms. With some small complexes found founded by only in Gasolin or in network plus. And all complexes that are done by network plus contain field products with possible non-one-to-one mapping between the nodes. And we observe that actually some complexes are correctly split in Gasolin and joined in the network blast. But we also found that some complexes are in Gasolin are actually smaller than the corresponding ones in network blast, because of the strictness of our function score. And we showed that fixing a maximum size, like in network blast, for complexes can be a huge deal. Because if we consider, for example, one of the solutions found by both algorithms, Protestant complex, we can actually see that the Protestant complex is actually bigger than 15 proteins, contains more than 15 proteins. Because we can observe that geo categories are still significant if we include more than 15 proteins. And we showed, found that our solution, Gasolin, outperforms network blast, which is 10 times smaller, which is bigger. 10 times slower than our solution. And before the end, I want to show you another interesting application of Gasolin to the local alignment of contact maps. Contact maps are graphs representing a 2D model of 3D structures of proteins, in which nodes are amino acids, and the edges connect to amino acids if their distance in space is less than a fixed cutoff. And the goal is to identify common structural models or conserved binding sites in these structures. We need a family, need the same family of proteins or different families of proteins. And this is actually a portion of the, this is actually an example of the solution we found in this application. And in conclusion, what are the future extension we want to apply to our solution? We want to include non-one-to-one mapping between the proteins in our current framework. And we want also to, if possible, improve the current scoring function to reach a better approximation of the size of real conserved complexes because of the strictness of our function score. And I want to thank the following people. I want to thank the group of Catania, University, Professor Ferro, Professor Pugliese, Professor Junior, and I want to thank also Professor Lorenz for his collaboration to our work in the alignment of contact maps. Thank you.
We removed nodes having
less than a threshold, because we this is just a trick for the execution of our algorithm. We could also not perform that step. We could consider all the nodes in the networks. The first step is important. That is to remove nodes that have no offsets in all species, because we are sure that they won't be considered in the final alignment, because we want to map nodes both on topology and on similarity. The second question is about edges. Yes, we of course we could start from edges instead of nodes. This will increase the complexity of the problem, because we have too many combinations we have to take into account. But we can we actually can start from if we start from we can exploit the ontology relations between products to make the initial alignment of nodes. So it's good, it's sufficient. It's sufficient to make the alignment, the initial alignment.
So, strings is not the primary total interaction data, it contains inferred total interaction. And one of the inference is based on ontology. So, this means that total interaction is found in human, is transferred to mouse, to rabbit. So, if you're interested to know whether total interactions are conserved in evolution, you shouldn't use strings, because it's biased. But you should use a primary interaction database.
Yeah, this is this was a big problem to find an appropriate database. Actually, I didn't say this, but we filtered the TPIs in each network, because we didn't consider all the interactions we can find in the database, because they are so many that we can we have a very big network, and we consider only the experimentally verified interactions, because string is actually divides interactions into four or five categories. They are interactions that are experimentally verified, that are interactions that are found by co-regulation. I mean, there are many sources of data, and they categorize these kind of interactions, and we only consider the experimentally verified interaction. But of course, we can use any source, any database.
Okay, we can have one last question, while the next speaker, please, can come and put out the presentation.
The question is, if the apps are based only on this sort of reduction, regarding the nature of interaction between residues,
I didn't.
Yeah, are based on a distance record.
For contact mass or for?
For contact mass.
Okay, see.
Okay, are based on distance record between carbon alpha and carbon alpha.
Yes.
So
yes, yes.
The nature of the kind of
distance is. Okay, to be precise, distance is between two representative powers. Usually, carbon alpha, yes. The most important, but you can also consider carbon beta, but it is not present in one amino acid, I don't remember which. Of course, it's the distance between two representative atoms. Yes.
Okay, so we can move on.
Yes.
We have now Ricardo Vicedo.